Hello and welcome to Dynamic, the online science videos blog. Here, the available things takes you from physics to life and life to physics. So, today is the time for some experiment of thermodynamics. So, don't waste your time. Let's go. Oh, sorry. But no need to say sorry, because it's my today's topic. You know, every liquid want to be in a shape that consists of very less volume all time. So, and this phenomena is called surface tension. So this water consists just like a spherical shape, because a sphere consists of very less volume than any other shape. But it's not my topic. Let me ask. I'm sure, and even you also, that this water will be disappear after 1 or 2 hours. And the surface will go towards dryness. Why? Where does the water go? And what changes are occur in that period of time? Okay, let's ask to the people. I have put some water on this plain surface, then what would happen after 2 or 3 hours?
This surface will be dry.
Where does the water go?
The water will convert into vapor.
Then what thermodynamical changes are occur in this process?
I don't know.
I think I don't have knowledge about it, so I don't know.
Then what would happen after 2 or 3 hours?
This water will change into stone.
What thermodynamical changes are occur in this process?
I don't know.
That was a good experience, because people are clearly know that the water will convert into vapor. But that's not enough, because they don't know what changes are occur in this process and what exactly happens in that period of time. Let me explain. Now, when we put some water on the surface, then a single molecule of water interacts with 100 of air molecule in every second. And the air molecule has some kinetic energy and they has some displacement, so the kinetic energy converts into work done. And the air molecule has some internal energy. So according to the first law of thermodynamics, the given energy is equal to the internal energy and the work done. So that is why the water molecule absorbs heat from the air molecule and converts into vapor. But just wait, we are missing something. You know, in this whole process, there is no change in temperature. Just like a little bit changes, the negligible change. But in normal life, when we have to change the phase of water, we have to boil it. You know, we have to change the temperature from 0 to 100 degrees centigrade. But in this process, there is no change in temperature. So how we can apply the first law of thermodynamics? The reason is latent heat. So the latent heat is the required heat to change the state without changing its temperature. So the latent heat of water for vaporization is 540 calories per gram. So the single mole of water absorbs 540 calories from the air molecule and converts into vapor. But what would happen if I took one piece of ice and put it on the normal environment? The process will be same. This ice will convert into water. But there is only one difference, that this ice take very less time than the vaporization. Why? Because the latent heat of vaporization is 7 times greater than to the latent heat of melting. So the latent heat of melting is just 80 calories per gram. And that is why the ice takes very less time than the vaporization. I'm giving you some homework. Let's take some milk and the water and make difference within their latent heat. You will get something more. If you get some information from my video, please subscribe to my channel.